Just as the wheels of the Indian Republic started rolling on 26th January 1950, a new age dawned upon the horizon of some remote villages located on the border of West Bengal and erstwhile Bihar. These villages on the New Delhi-Howrah main line were chosen to be the site for a locomotive building workshop under the Indian Railways, a plant which would bring these little-known places to national prominence. On 26th January 1950, Srimati Basanti Devi inaugurated the production at the Loco Building Factory.
Chitranjan Locomotive Works is the first production unit of Indian Railways. It was started on 26th Jan 1950, the first public day. Lot of pride of nation was involved in starting steam locomotive production in India. The first steam locomotive at that time was produced and flagged off on 1st November 1950 by Dr. Rajendra Prasad, the first president of India.
The first steam loco built at this facility was christened Deshbandhu, as homage to the great statesman Sri Chittaranjan Das. The name of the plant was also changed from Loco Building Factory to Chittaranjan Locomotive Works. Since then, the nation has seen a lot of transformation, and so has this indigenous loco building unit. Many of us have noticed Chittaranjan Station while travelling on the Howrah-Patna main line, or must have seen the road sign on NH2 which says Chittaranjan 11 kilometers. But barely some of us know what technological treasure lies therein. We bring you a glimpse into the sheer brilliance that is involved in the manufacture of war horses for the Indian Railways.
So far, 8,700 locomotives have been produced, out of which 2,351 steam locomotives, 842 diesel, and rest of it electric locomotives have been produced. So far, conventional variety of electric locomotives have been produced to the level of more than 4,500, and about 950 C-phase locomotives have been produced.
This majestic plant has never failed to deliver what the nation desires of it. The CLW presents a seamless amalgamation of state-of-the-art technology and a highly skilled human workforce. To begin with, the shell is fabricated using different components of mild steel like sidewall, center sill, complete underframe and driver's cab, after cutting plates of different sizes to the required dimensions. In addition, certain products are manufactured indigenously by its own foundry. A three-phased induction motor is used as the main traction motor on the locomotive, which mainly consists of stator housing and rotor. The stator is fabricated through rolling of plates of different sizes on which copper coils are laid down as per design. The rotor assembly consists mainly of laminations through which rotor bars are embedded. A rotor shaft is used for coupling of rotor to the drive gear assembly. Bare wheel discs along with axles are procured from outside. Turning of bare wheel disc is done to achieve the design profile, after which wheel discs are pressed on both sides of the axle, followed by mounting of axle boxes. The bogie is fabricated after cutting of plates in different sizes. Traction motors are mounted on assembled wheel sets and put on the bogie at different locations. Necessary sub-assemblies like springs, dampers and the likes are provided. The shell is first painted on both sides and then equipped with pipes of different sizes. Thereafter, cables are laid for different equipments. Mounting of different equipments is done inside as well as under the shell. The shell, after mounting of different equipments, is lowered on the assembled bogies and necessary adjustments are carried out to achieve the desired clearances. The locomotive is tested for proper functioning of all the equipments under different conditions. Necessary field trials are also carried out by running the locomotive as per desired norms. Later, the locomotive is dispatched to nominated sheds.
Chitranjan Locomotive Works is helping the zonal railways in disseminating knowledge about three-phase technology, which is the state of the art technology today. Various electric loco sheds, technical staff are taking help from the unit, and training is being imparted in CLW as well as deploying staff to their sheds also spread over all over the Indian Railways. CLW has various important certifications. We have ISO 9001 certification for quality. We have ISO 14001 certification for environment. And we also have OSHA's 18001 certification for occupational health.
The CLW is not just about metals and machines. The human factor is equally important. For the members of the CLW family, a highly secured and self-sufficient township has been constructed, consisting of more than 9,000 quarters spread across 18 square kilometers. The CLW township has about 200 kilometers of metalled roads. Through a network of 350 kilometers long pipeline, drinking water is supplied to the households in the CLW township. The water is extensively treated to make it absolutely safe for drinking. Essential services have also been incorporated, with 37 schools and one college. The CLW Women's Welfare Organization runs Shishu Bihar and Asha Kiran schools. For the convenience of residents, the township has banks, a police station, post office, telephone exchange, market, community centers, and other recreational facilities such as clubhouses, cinema hall, auditorium, and a beautiful children's park. The CLW has up-to-date facilities for sports as well. There are various playgrounds in Chittaranjan. Players are provided with training in outdoor and indoor games like badminton, football, cricket, basketball, golf, table tennis, bridge, and even archery. CLW players have won laurels in various disciplines in the past. Healthcare too is an area of priority, and we have built a 200-bed hospital with the latest modular OT and state-of-the-art ICCU. Latest technologies in healthcare have been installed for service of the people, and 7 health units spread across the township. As an organization of repute and responsibility, the CLW does not simply dump its waste matter into nearby water bodies. The sewage supplies are treated diligently and then released into the river Ojoy. organic wastes are sent as manure for agriculture. Which amply illustrates the bona fide intentions of the town planners. The township has been awarded with the Golden Peacock Award for Environment Management.
Chitranjan Locomotive Works is a beautiful township in itself. The environment is very good, lot of greenery, pollution free environment, and water bodies, lakes with a boat club are there. There is a locomotive children park also, where a toy train, which is the smallest toy train and drawn by a small miniature steam locomotive, which is made to the scale in Chitranjan. I must appreciate that people living in the township are very happy, and it contains a healthy environment, and lot of work also has been done under the Swachhta Abhiyan jo hamare mananiya Pradhan Mantri Mahoday ne shuru kiya hai, usko uddeshya lekar ke humne kaafi kaary karne ka prayas kiya hai.
Much like any efficient organization, everything here is managed and controlled by highly efficient and dedicated administration. Housed in a decorated and well-constructed building, the administration never fails short to assess and act the way it ought to. At the helm of this efficient workforce is a bright and hard-working general manager who leads by example.
Taking a call from Make in India campaign by the Honorable Prime Minister of India, we have tried to develop wheels of indigenous origin, and we are also developing control systems for three-phase locomotives in association with CDAC, Center for Design and Advanced Computing. We are using at present 97% components in the locomotive from indigenous origin, and only 3% components are imported, for which also we are making efforts to indigenize them. At present, we are producing three-phase locomotives of 6,000 horsepower. Very soon, we are going to produce locomotives of 9,000 horsepower with Japanese technology at a new unit being opened at Dankuni near Kolkata.
Gaining accolades and awards through its journey for the past 6 decades, this unit is now all set to stretch its footprint to the district of Hooghly, with its new unit coming up at Dankuni. The work is in full swing at this site, and it is expected to commence work by January 2016.
Apart from this, we are trying to use modern technology and include various other useful features in the locomotive, such as hotel load converters, IGBT based PCN compliant technology, AC cab for the pilots and drivers, and several other such modern developments have taken place. Last year, a high-speed trial of 160 kmph carried out on Delhi-Agra section. The locomotives are provided by Chitranjan Locomotive Works, and we are also trying to assemble 200 kmph locomotive in the unit.
This esteemed institution has been fortunate to have illustrious men of honor to have laid their feet on its soil. Beginning with Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Lal Bahadur Shastri, and Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, the list of delegates visiting this organization is long and memorable.
We hope that in near future we will be able to fulfill the expectations of the people and help Indian Railways to carry the future requirements of the nation.
Excellence is a way of life at the CLW, and it strives to beat the high standards set by itself. The CLW is deservingly proud of its achievements. CLW is the Chitranjan Locomotive Works, and it is the prime motive power provider to the nation.